in the league table, but they win or lose?
Yes, it's true. I think that we're playing that kind of football that where we know that every point is important for us, and we have won against the smaller team. We win. That was very important for us, that we take all important points that we can get. That we, against Armenia, against Andorra, mm-hmm. we were the favorites. So we have to win this game. And then our mission is to take at least two wins against the big team.
Yes,
Romania, Czechia, or mm-hmm. or Holland.
During last match, you just put in serious troubles Czech Republic away from home.
Yeah, that was very, very sad because it was... we were down 3-1, then in the end 3-2, we scored 3-3, and 88 minutes we had our attacker had a great, great chance to score a goal with a header, and this Chelsea goalkeeper made a great save, and then like 15 seconds after the save, counter-attacked, and they scored 4-3 game, 4-3 goal, so it was very sad. We could have won that game in the end, but this is football.
Yes, I see. As for you now, you've been requested from very various clubs throughout Europe. We already stated in England, in Germany, someone has written about Hamburg, and Russian too, where it seems that Spartak Mosca has been in agreement with you. But you have chosen Italy, have chosen Lecce. It was a special choice by you.
Yes, I had been contacted by many clubs before Lecce, like, okay, not many, 4 or 5 clubs have been interesting, and before I signed with Lecce, I was already 90% sure to sign with Spartak Moscow, because all the papers were clear, and I was medical test there, and it was clear. Then I got a call here from Italy, and they said that, yeah, that Mr. Zeman is taking over the Lecce team, that he is now the head coach, and he would be interesting to take me in his team. Mm-hmm. And of course, Italy, one of the hardest league, one of mm-hmm. the difficult, one of the special league in the world. And of course, if you get a chance to mm-hmm. come and play in this league, you don't get every year a chance to come and play in this league.
It's sort of a challenge for yourself, for your career.
Of course, it's a challenge, and it's great for Finland, because now I'm the first Finnish player. I'm the only player that is playing here. So it's good to open the doors from Finland to come here too.
Oh, perfect. And finally, to end this interview, you have now burst into the national team after 5 goals in the opening 5 matches of World Cup qualification. But you are Finland's brightest prospect. But as for you, Alexei, apart from yourself, who are your teammates who can mean the future for the Finland national team?
I think future is Mikael Forsell. He has been long one of the best players for a few years already, and he's still 24 years old. He's still a young player.
You mean too?
Forsell, Mikael Forsell.
Uh-huh, yeah.
The one who plays in Chelsea.
Yeah.
And I think we have, midfield is pretty young. I think we have good midfield there, young players, midfield. And my brother is coming up now. He's now 18 years. He's too very high recommended in Finland. So I think we have many young players that is playing abroad now, that is not playing in the first team abroad, but they're going through good school abroad. Mm-hmm. So I think if we don't qualify this year, I think next year mm-hmm. we have good chance if like I said, if we have luck on our side.
So the future may be brighter for Finnish soccer.
I think it can be the only bad thing that Jari Litman is getting older now. That's the only dark side in Finnish football, because he's absolutely the best player we ever had, and he's the captain, and he's the Finnish football.
Okay, Alexei, thank you for your participation to our schedule Calcio Mondo, and hopefully to see you in every success on fields.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.